Let's start equal with the 49th example. A solid body rotated about a stationary axis so that its angular velocity is a function of phi, where omega naught and a are positive. At t is equal to 0, phi is 0. Okay. It is also given that at t is equal to 0, the initial angular position is 0. Find the time dependence of rotation angle. So I can say this is nothing but angular velocity is nothing but derivative of angular position with respect to time. So it will be this. So d phi upon omega naught minus a phi will be equal to dt. And then we will do integrating on both sides. Time varies from 0 to t and phi varies from 0 to phi any time t. So 1 upon, now we know that the integration of 1 upon ax plus b will be ln of ax plus b divided by coefficient of x. So similarly, the integration will be ln of omega naught minus a phi divided by coefficient of phi minus a is equal to dt. The integration of dt will be t limit 0 to t. Here also we need to put limit where phi varies from 0 to any time t phi. Okay, now I'll write it here. So minus 1 upon a is common, and then upper limit ln of omega naught minus a phi upper limit minus ln of omega naught minus 0 upper limit minus lower limit is equal to time t. So it will be 1 upon a, ln a minus ln b will be ln of a by b, but due to this minus sign it will be ln of omega naught upon omega naught minus a phi, because the signs will change. Okay, and I can say like this. Or phi we need to find. So instead of transferring this minus sign, I will keep this at. So it will be ln of omega naught minus a phi upon omega naught. Omega naught equal to minus a t. So when I transfer this ln on this side, so it will be omega naught minus a phi upon omega naught is equal to e raised to minus a t. So omega naught minus a phi is equal to omega naught into e raised to minus a t. So omega naught minus omega naught into e raised to minus a t is equal to a phi. So phi will be equal to omega naught upon a in bracket 1 minus e raised to minus a t. And this is the angular position as a function of time. Now if I substitute this value of angular position in this equation of omega, I'll get omega at any time t. So omega will be equal to omega naught minus a phi, where angular position phi at any time t is known to us. So it will be omega naught by a in bracket 1 minus e raised to minus a t. This a get cancelled. Omega naught minus omega naught plus omega naught e raised to minus a t. So this get cancelled. So it will be omega naught into e raised to minus a t. So that is angular velocity at any time t in this motion. And these are the answers to this question. Okay. Thank you.